following program may not be suitable for younger listeners. This show does not reflect the views of this channel or its affiliates. Please stand by.
But wait, there's more.
Salvation. Eternal salvation. Or triple your money back. The Church of the Subgenius. Bring you another 33 minutes of condensed Uraglic function over the quality audio-visual techniques exacerbated and complicated by the Church of the Subgenius. Copyright 1985-86.
Oh, doctors for mom.
She said, cutting her own legs off in what was to be the foment of a startling new trend among the so-called punk detelahensia.
Should any other shows be heard from or contacted in the course of this show, the listener is advised to remain calm and only contact listed or unlisted officials in the event of any material from this radio or other listening device being inhaled during broadcast. Small animals or other children becoming exposed to the ultra-high or ultra-low shocks and brain frequencies constantly scanned throughout our program should seek shelter in an approved safety unit only. This is Walter Teasdale reminding you that it's often a photon that light releases, but truth is, not everyone gets the picture. Hoping your time is all time and all your unpermissible truths are happy truths. Here's your host,
Reverend Ivan Stang. Dear friends, and this is KNON 90.9 FM in Dallas, Texas.
Wait a minute, I gotta rest.
Come on, Hal. We're already 2 hours late for the show. Oh, watch it with that water, man. We don't have much.
So where's the road?
I think the road. I think it's behind us.
Behind us?
Well, what the?
I thought we were going towards the road.
These little air cans.
Look, we've got to
get. Give me some of that air before
our
it's
show.
Gone.
Before there's just a big blank space and nothing on.
I hope it lasts till we get there.
Yeah, I know.
God, my feet are killing me too.
See, the sun's kill this me. Way, so the road's got to be over there.
Yeah, but the moss is growing on the other side
and
of that.
The radiation warning signs are all pointing that way.
It looks kind of menacing. And the sun's just coming up.
If that really is the sun.
Yeah, the sun's just coming up.
It looks pretty weird.
Boy, the air smells
hot,
good.
Yeah.
Just wish.
I don't think this is
like the Cactus Wren, Arizona's national.
I don't think this is Arizona, Hal. This is Texas.
Yeah, there
Should
it is.
Be.
We've got to be in Texas.
Let's get out of here. It's creepy.
I just hope the Indians haven't set one of their deadly traps.
Hey, watch out!
Boy, we'll never get back to KPFA at this rate.
KPFA?
I thought we were going to
KNON.
All we have to do is reach the mobile field antenna, and we can start our broadcast.
And also, we should just be able to see the rocket from here somewhere.
I'm afraid that went down several hours ago.
A rocket?
Yo, rescue's
it would have
out
shown
of
up on our locator,
yeah.
But...
Hey, look over there.
Just a natural rock formation.
No,
nothing to be afraid of.
It
was moving.
It looks like a big scary monster, I know. You know, out in the desert, things can look like things that they aren't.
It's called
the spirit of the desert.
Mirage.
They call them duendes.
Don't talk about the duendes.
Yeah, the Indians say they're little, shriveled, dried up, mummified like beings about a foot tall that grab onto you and bite you
just
like a
this rock over here. Just,
oh!
Just tear a piece off.
These cactuses feel like plastic.
These rocks are made out of paper mache.
This tree's
made out of a spring.
Maybe we can get some water, huh?
I don't know, you guys. What does that symbol mean?
This is Bed Springs.
We don't have any more coffee.
Doesn't that mean biochemical hazard?
No more sugar, no more beans. You can't figure out where the road is.
At least we got a good astronomical observation last night.
Check out the man pack, see if we can figure out where we are.
We better get a Geiger counter reading.
Star called it SS-433.
It's kind of cold out here.
They don't call it nuclear winter for nothing.
Readings, we can take another reading a little later on. I just hope we've got something to say when it's time for that broadcast.
Yeah, no kidding.
Well,
I lost
a lot of people
script.
Are counting on us. Remember that. All 10 listeners in the Bay Area.
The Bay
they've
Area.
Got to hear us, or they or just can't
no,
make
gotta,
it
this
through
is Texas.
The morning, as it were.
Come on, guys.
Oh, look, a jackalope, Arizona's national rabbit.
I thought those were extinct.
There it goes.
Okay, oh, it's glowing.
It had little speakers in its head.
Yeah, probably where that's coming from.
It's probably an observation drone.
You know, they say this whole area of the desert is haunted. Hold it, I've got a rock in my shoe.
For those tales. Bob came through here years ago, Hal.
The rock?
Hey, put your shoes
that's
back
that's the crystal.
On.
That rock crawled away.
Well, let
and
me
look,
have...
there's a crack in it.
The Moki Hanna crystal.
Yeah, let me have some of that Moki. Cracked crystal.
Yes. Now we do. Let us head topographically back toward the station.
Good
yeah,
idea,
no kidding.
Doctor. And
we're already
on the way,
late.
We can have some of that special frop you've been telling me about.
Yes, let us do so. So anyway, I filled out the death certificate, sent it on to Bethesda. Pneumothorax area was completely full with fluid.
Well, I must say, we sure put one over on the American people that time. They still believe there was no second gunman on that grassy knoll. Boy, would I
didn't even see the grassy knoll on the stage.
No, it was all fake, all phony.
But you were standing right next to him.
Yeah, but, you know, you can't let on in a situation like that, involving national security, that is.
Well, I remember going to the airport with Bob that night, meeting him there in San Francisco as he flew in for the show. Little
yes.
did he know that we'd wind up on the wrong end of my gun.
His teeth were clenched around the stub of that pipe. It was a disgusting sight to see the snarling rictus of death on the Epoch's face.
After relaxing on the lake, Bob's ready to have a great time entertaining his friends. Right, Bob? Bob? Bob?
This is the church that's gonna kick ass on the normals, the mediocrities, the pink boys, the hippies, the trekkies, and the admin.
I wonder.
What?
If God were to come to Earth, would they find him so strange that they would be afraid, and would they shoot him?
Did not his son come once, Pedro?
And they nailed him to a cross.
And then spent 2,000 years learning to believe in him. All things take time, Pedro.
We would certainly come out on top again if we succeed in being defeated.
You talk like a madman.
But I live like a sane one. I was a fascist when Mussolini was on top. Now that he has been deposed, I am anti-fascist. When the Germans were here, I was fanatically pro-German. Now I'm fanatically pro-American. You'll find no more loyal parties in all of Italy than myself.
You're a shameful opportunist. What you don't understand is that it's better to die on your feet than to live on your knees.
You have it backwards. It's better to live on your feet than to die on your knees.
Enjoy life like Bob.
That is so true, dear friend, so true. There is a vast, nameless conspiracy struggling to control your mind. And it only allows you 1 hour of slack per week. That hour comes at 11 o'clock every Sunday night on KNON. Dear friends, there are only 5 basic things that can light up your mind. sex, drugs, great music, religion, or the Hour of Slack radio ministry, sponsored by the Church of the Subgenius on KNON, 11 o'clock every Sunday night. The Hour of Slack, the radio voice of the saint of sales, the living avatar of Slack, J.R. Bob Dobbs. The Church of the Subgenius began in Dallas, Texas. Now your ears can experience the auditory hallucination, which is the Word of Bob, direct from the mysterious founders of this mystic cult devoted to getting us all the slack we deserve. But the Hour of Slack at 11 o'clock Sundays is not just a bunch of dead preachers preaching dead sermons to dead congregations. Nay, nay. The Hour of Slack is music from the most primitive to the most advanced. It is sound collages from TV shows and movie soundtracks that you'll pray had never existed. It is tormented, gut-ripping original rants and jeremiads from top subgenius preachers and bands the world over. It is the most intense barrage of experimental sound effects ever heard over stereo headphones. It is the Word of Bob. Hope for the mutants in a crumbling world. The Hour of Slack, the most significant weekly event in the history of mankind. Sundays at 11 p.m., The Hour of Slack, the show, every episode of which you'll wish you had taped. And the reason I taped that one, friends, is because that's going to be our new Hour of Slack promo, and all I have to do is add in 49 layers of sound effects. See? I save myself some time at your expense. But you know, at the same time, most traffic accidents happen within a few miles of home. Did you know that? Even at low speeds, a sudden stop or fender bender can cause severe injury to occupants who are not wearing a safety belt. Take time to buckle up, dear friends, even on the shortest trips. This safety message from KNON and the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration does not conflict in any major way with doctrine from the Church of the Subgenius. But I'll tell you what, dear friends, there are those of you who have strayed. Oh, you have strayed so far. And this is a good follow-up to that ad I just read. I got this memo here in my secret box here at the station, in the Reverend Stang box, and it says, it's from the station managers. It says, folks, it's time for me to get down to the nitty-gritty. KNON needs more money. Some of the shows and some entire formats have been doing a lousy job in actually getting any money to the station, and time is running out. To be absolutely fair and to give some very talented DJs a chance to keep their shows, I'm going to give you 1 month to contact these people who haven't paid and have them get their money in. The results that I have in my hand on December 1st, 1986 will be the results I base my programming on. I have hundreds of people on file who want to be DJs at KNON. Unless there's a substantial improvement, many of you are not going to be here for our next pledge drive. And attached to that so-called dear friends is a long list of those of you who pledged during the pledge drive and hadn't sent in money. Oh man, I mean it tears me up, folks. I can't believe that the subgeniuses have embarrassed me personally, and so much more important, J.R. Bob Dobbs himself. Are y'all a bunch of liars? There are those of you fine, fine listeners out there who did send in their check. And then there's a whole bunch that must have thought, oh, well, I want to cheer up Reverend Stang while they're having a pledge. I want to make a funny joke over the phone to someone. I want to do anything but send in my check. Well, friends, the sound you hear right now is subliminally programming you to hurry up and write that check and send it to KNON, and I'm going to give you that box number. Get that pencil ready. And I don't think I'm going to continue this show any longer until you do write that check. And actually, you know, don't let it sit around on your desk. Go ahead and send it in, because frankly, if at least half the people on this list don't go ahead and send in the money they promised they'd send, there ain't going to be no hour of slack, and I wouldn't blame the station one bit for taking it off, because they can't survive. None of the shows can survive without your money out there in the audience. You sniveling worms who dare to steal the word of Bob. It's just like stealing the word of Bob. Bob don't like it, friends. Bob don't like it too. He's gonna come in an hour you know not and visit upon ye bad luck if you don't get that pledge money that you promised in. It's really disappointing. But those of you who have sent it in, I'll be calling you up personally to thank you and and so forth.
Look, stick your hand in the water. It's radio water.
Back here.
It is.
This isn't real water at all. We're on the show again.
It might even be real water, but it's traveling at such a high speed we can't tell. But we're traveling at a speed somewhat relative to that.
Stick your hand in it.
Oh, no, I don't want to lose my fingers.
Garbage.
You stick your hand.
Hey, watch. Ah!
Boy. What a shame. Now put these other fingers
on. Look, the little seagulls are eating away at it now.
Yes, there goes Jonathan Living Fliggle, the infant seagull with a large palpitating severed digit, and all the birds of Derbyshire and Somersetshire and Warwickshire. Oh, look, there's a light on the interrogator main board. Are you sure the overcharge isn't too much, Doctor?
No, no, not at all. It's the same old thing.
It's definitely underwhelming.
Okay. All we can do is
a living soul on the front. The people of the Nephites.
In every cry of every man, every infant's cry of fear.
Words of all the holy prophets who had spoken.
Yeah.
In every breath, in every band.
For they knew.
Show called.
I left my radio on and I caught my dog listening to your program.
I wouldn't let a
dog. You might have
to
eviscerate that dog now. Might have to edit its memory, as it were. Practice time control on the poor cur.
Just erase the mutt's memory.
What the hell was this about F-rays coming from dogs anyway?
F-rays coming from dogs? Man-rays coming from dogs. Man-rays negatives coming from dogs.
Undetectable F-rays.
Ooh, scary.
Undetectable by normal instruments.
Oh, sorry, Doug. I didn't mean to be scary again.
Only subgenius.
Are your little red lights are going? Yeah. This is a scary show. It's always scary. I don't know. That's what it says in the cue cards over there.
We
believe in Monday morning going back to work.
And the sunlight shafts.
Does Bob have a credo?
Bob Dobbs. And Bob's credo is something we can't even tell you over the air, dear friends. It's so nasty. Because Bob likes to have so much fun. And this is a church that's trying to bring you to a slack awareness. If we have to beat it into your head. And that's what we call in the church, in our highfalutin church dogma and jargon, acubeating. Acubeating, that ancient Tibetan art which can bring you to justice and transfer pain from one part of your body to another. It's really a miracle. And you can send that money to KNON at P.O. Box 710909 in Dallas, Texas. If you want to keep this show on the air, you heard me. I'm going to give that number again. It's KNON's box number. If you want to hear anything like the word of Bob, anything half decent left on the radio, you need to send that money to KNON, P.O. Box 710709, Dallas, Texas, 75371, because the conspiracy really is out to get this station. And I mean, this is the conspiracy, folks. Oh, by the way, that was you have been hearing there was more puzzling evidence from Dr. Hal Robbins and puzzling evidence on engineer Bob Nelson on the more than an hour less than a show in Berkeley, California. We'll be bringing back some more samples of that at any minute. But first, this message.
Your blazing guns still the bad man's lusty aliveness. Look how quietly he sprawls on the blood-stained ground. kill him again. Shoot the nesters, greasers, horse thieves, and cattle rustlers. The crows peck their eyeballs in the scrub and the sagebrush. All the others may come out. But you, gunslinger, will go on shooting, smiling, cool, without unseemly passion. Shoot the blonde, true blue as the yellow rose of Texas, whom you won in a poker game in a Dodge City saloon. Shoot her father, the ranch owner. Shoot the sheriff. Shoot the posse. Shoot the birds out of the sky. Shoot the mountain cats in their dark hollows. Son of a gun. Gatherer of darkness and silence. Rider into the bloody sunset. Rushes in behind you.
Man, and I've got to cut out of that one, see, because I'm not sure. Dr. Philo Drummond sent me that tape, and I'm not sure what it is exactly, but I think that is an actual part of an actual Ku Klux Klan release, because other stuff that was on here was just unbelievably, nightmarishly racist. I mean, God, I really want to do a race hour of Slack, but I'm afraid that people would not understand. Some of the stuff in our collection is so horrifying that I feel like people should know it exists. But at the same time, it's like if we play it, half of the people hearing it go, "What? They really believe this stuff? I can't believe." And so we get in terrible trouble, and everyone who works at the station the next day has to answer all the complaining phone calls because people just don't understand bull data. You know, you can't present an example of something you hate without them thinking that you love it. I just don't get it. But this is Negative Land.
Centuries as a method of torture. Place someone's head inside of a bell and ring it. And eventually, they'll go insane. And eventually, they'll go insane. And eventually,
you're beaten down. You're irritable. Your mental and physical health are suffering.
Shapes inside.
Yellow, black, and shapes inside.
Oh,
death, and what else?
It has kind of wedge shapes inside.
Yellow, black.
Black and yellow and...
And with...
Rectangular.
Wedge shapes inside.
Oh, I see them everywhere. Do you hear me?
They're just lie back.
Black. Well, you see, friends, this is negative land still.
Do you hear me?
This is actually, this part, the last half of the show is going to be part three of the Subgenius anti-drug special. But before I get into that tape, it's actually a rerun from Old Hour of Slack. But I just discovered this dub version of a Nina Hagen song in the station's record collection. This is something that, I mean, I haven't really heard it. But I wanted to have a tape of it. So, I'm going to play it. This is... Quit worrying about what it means, friends. That's the important thing.
Do you hear me?
There.
Everywhere. Do you hear me?
There.
Do you hear me?
Mrs.
Rectangular.
Mrs. Rectangular.
Monotonous. I guess, well, that's art for you, huh? Well, this is, forget that. It didn't change fast enough. This is the Swinging Erudites. Let's get to some real class here. This is Reverend Cleve Duncan of the Mighty Subgenius Church, and at playing with a band called the Swinging Erudites, doing this Ramones hit.
Nothing to do, nowhere to go. I want to be sedated. Get me to the airport, put me on a plane. Hurry, 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 before I go insane. Can't control my fingers, can't control my brain. Oh no, oh no, no. 2024 hours to go. I want to be sedated. Nothing to do, nowhere to go. I want to be sedated. Just put me in a wheelchair and get me to the show. Hurry, 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 before I go loco. Can't control my fingers, can't control my toes. Oh no, 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 no. Thank you.
Yeah.
24 hours to go. I want to be yesterday. Nothing to do, nowhere to go. I want to be yesterday. In a wheelchair, get me to the shore. Hurry, 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 before I go loco. I can't control my fingers, can't control my toes. Oh no, oh no, no. Ba 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 ba. I wanna be sedated. Ba 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 ba. I wanna be sedated. Ba 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 ba. I wanna be sedated. Ba 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 ba.
Bob, he wants to be sedated. That's the swinging erudites, dear friends. And what follows is not an example of what we think you should do, but what we should, what you should never, ever do.
Doctor, doctor, here. Take some more of this. Have some of that. Maybe the show will finish and we'll get to make another tape.
Oh no, more prescriptions again. I don't know if I can keep up with all these prescriptions and all these callers.
It's good for you. I'll take care of the callers.
Fake shows.
I'll take care of the fake callers.
Oh God, this is a genius thing. It's more than
the pills, doctor.
I can't. I don't think I can keep up with it. I mean, it's like there's too much of it. There's letters that's come in the mail. These weird magazines. These characters that show up at the door. These bobbies. They want to know things. They want to know how to run their lives. Or what should I do, Reverend Stang, about...
Open to libel and slander. That's our lawyer now. Oh, my God, he's here.
Hey, I feel much better now. Oh, man.
That's because Bob sent this for you.
Yeah, these normal souls are amazing. You can drink them, you can smoke them, you can eat them. God, who knows what you can do.
You can even snort them.
Try rubbing one up under my gums.
I'm going to try a line of this human soul here, if you'll excuse me a minute. I'll go. Oh, now that's what I call soul.
Let me try some of that. Jesus, that must have been a fairly intelligent normal.
Oh no, that wasn't a normal. That was. That
God,
was
I think I got some of his memories off of that. Wow. Yeah, it's like I'm seeing this little woman. In the 40s, just for a second. It's probably the guy's mom.
Yeah.
God, you can snort their souls.
Yeah.
And these you little primal gotta, memories come.
You've just got to give them fine lotion and dry them out first.
Okay. God, how long have you guys known about this? I mean, was this something the Indians had down there?
Yeah, yeah. It's too rainy to light a fire to smoke a soul a lot of times, so they just they dry it and keep it in with volcanic rock as an absorbent, and they just grind it up and snort it through huge
caves. They didn't have the technology to extract souls. I mean, how'd they get them under pressure? How'd they get them into the canisters?
They don't do it that way. They just feed them the right amount of herbs and plants, and the soul just drips out of the nasal and anal.
You're
and,
kidding.
No, it just...
Why can't we do that?
We can if we got the right pills. It's kind of, you know, it's well, all organic. I mean, you know, there's two ways you can extract. You go high technology, or you can go with just kerosene and a couple of guys
Bob
with bare...
Why set up these extraction machines? I mean,
well,
what's this?
All you
got to
do is you dig a little pit. You dig a little pit in the ground, you line it with plastic, peg down with wood.
Uh-huh.
And then you put the body in.
A normal, right?
Yeah.
Any normal? Or
any
does
normal,
have to be, I mean, it...
Any normal that isn't dead yet. The soul is still in him, right?
Uh-huh.
Okay, then you cover him with kerosene and acetone. And then you just jump up and down on him until it turns kind of green and thick. Then you remove him, strain the liquid. Then you boil it and you add sulfuric acid.
But then there's some kind of ritualistic... I mean, what actually causes the transmutation?
Well, there's a group of people around the pit adding a psychic element of the alchemy, you see. That's, they concentrate. And,
oh,
and
yeah, because they don't have the soul amplifier.
Right, so it's done with psychic methods.
Oh, man.
And then, after
God,
it's boiled...
that's incredible.
After it's boiled,
a bunch of
add,
Brazilian tribal jungle people...
And Bolivians. And Bolivians, both. They both do it. In the lowlands on both sides there. And then you boil, they boil a soul, they actually boil
little
the soul.
Little combo souls.
Yeah,
right?
They boil, and little Koya souls too, you know. And they boil them, and then when it starts to thicken, they add another liquid. It's some kind of corrosive, I believe. And it turns into a thick white paste, and they just spread the soul out into the sun, and it dries. And then you just have to chop it up.
They'd probably think we were idiots for crystallizing them and compressing them. And
yeah, well, I mean, it's...
It probably doesn't cost them, you know, it costs them a couple of necklaces or, you know, or
well,
a taper.
Well, they don't need electricity to do
their
it.
Their pet taper. And the most expense they've got. And it costs us $100,000 a year to keep these things pumping
along.
Well,
you see, we use
and
a lot of...
not to mention the bodies and the souls and getting rid
that's
of
the
them.
See, the body dissolves.
Storing them.
The body dissolves in the solution completely.
Well, do you do up the body too?
No, they just strain it out with a solid waste.
What do they do with that?
With that?
Put
they
it on
press
the...
it into little cakes and burn it, like for fires and stuff like that. They usually give it back to the guy's family.
How come the Western civilization didn't discover that?
Well, you see, it's
how come they haven't been ripped off yet? How come we didn't rip them off?
Well, because we can pay for soul and get it a lot cheaper from them than doing it up here, because, you know, like down there, nobody complains if you go through 400 or 500 bodies in one night, you know. You can sit around and smoke all the soul you want to.
Yeah, I guess it would be kind of questionable to
they got a lot
to
more
be digging
soul.
Pits in your backyard and throwing normal bodies in there.
Well, it's just little pressed cakes.
Noisy, if nothing
it's
else.
It's just little pressed cakes. Most people barbecue on them later, you know. You see?
Well, and then we've got to give half of them away to the... whatever, wherever they're taken on Jupiter.
Well, of course, the thing about
that weirds me out, man.
A lot of things weird me out. The fact is that you can't get any good soul here in the States, dry or liquid. It's always been cut with something. And I like my soul unstepped on myself, you know.
Oh, yeah, they'll use monkey souls, chimpanzee souls.
Hell, they just take up crystallized...
It's probably two-thirds...
They just take crystallized emotions and mix them in, for God's sake. I mean, you get a bad blast of rage mixed in with your soul, and the next thing you know, man, you...
That's probably what happened to me last week.
They put a lot of anguish in it, too, you know? It just makes you depressed. Whereas pure soul is nothing more than a psychic and, you know, almanic amplifier. And you know, if your soul's in good shape when you do pure soul, I mean, it's even better. But, you know, like, you put
the stuff that's been stepped on and mixed with monkey soul or alligator.
Yeah, next thing you know, your soul is...
It's tainted.
Know, very tainted.
Got
yeah.
holes eaten through it, you know?
Man, I wonder if that's what happened to Janer.
What happened to Janer?
Yeah.
Janer shoots soul.
Oh, I know. He's all... He magnetized my Palmer head. He calls it. Yeah, hey, give me some of that remagnetized Palmer. I won't do any demagnetized Trevino head.
See, that's a problem with Janer is doing that Palmer head, and you know it was not a good molecule to begin with, and you know he's just synthesizing more and more of bad stuff and making it purer and purer, and each time he makes it purer, it's more pure bad. That's his basic problem.
Running up demagnetized soul, bad golfer souls.
Yeah, can you imagine?
Thanks. manslaughter.
It is this doctor's opinion that anal sex was performed on the dead bodies after the brutal slaughter and was done. Details at 10.
My baby! My baby!
Where the subgenius beach party is, in Berkeley, and don't you wish you did?
Oh dear, that ding!
Great. Well, Dr. Hal, is there any way you can fight through the sound effects and tell us about the relationship between the themapods and the
well, usapods. The demopods and the myriapods got together at the
end. Themapods and usapods.
The themapods.
Script. We're supposed to.
I didn't understand that. I thought you meant this script right here, the one with the red lines on the cover. Listen, never read anything with red dots. I never believe anything with red dots. Never
read
sign on lines where
there are people you don't like on the show.
God, they're coming in from all sides.
Too many buttons to push, too many tape recorders to watch.
It was obvious that during the game they should not have launched ahead with that size of a rocket. They should have used a smaller rocket, not hurt so many people. Some perhaps, but not so many. As it turned out, JFK was turning to Governor Connally to tell him the name of the band that dare not speak his name and was shot because of that.
Thank you for your input, caller.
What does it sound like where you are? But what
does it sound like where you are?
What is weird?
Huh? So weird DJ dressed up in a crown of thorns and a dirty sheet starts kissing on you.
And don't forget to...
Oh, hi. I just wanted to remind you that the elementary school kids are coming in for their annual tour. And this year, try not to scare them, will you? All that making faces through the control room window and wearing your toupee sideways didn't do us any good, you know. Some of the teachers insist you're an idiot.
It's ho for horse, or metal beat his heart to swinging mood. While rats run up my trouser legs, roaches share my food. Rats and roaches nuzzle me when it's dark and hot. Love, love, it's all the same, mixing speed and pot. First a rat and then a roach are both as like as not. If I can't find a fix tonight, my marrow bones will rot. Goodbye, transcendent Tompkins Square, I haven't long to stay. A double jolt of heroin and I'll be on my way.
Yes, dear friends, here we are at home at on the airwaves of KNON 90.9 in Dallas, Fort Worth, Arlington. This is Reverend Ivan Stang with Dr. G. Gordon Gordon, and you better stop and explain, just, and credit, at least. We can never explain.
Who are those fools making those weird noises were that were playing on your radio?
Let's see, the music started off with a band called They Might Be Giants, which Reverend Bleepo Abernathy in Boston has been sending tapes of, and you'll hear them every now and then. But quite a bit of there was the show... less than an hour from San Francisco, or the Berkeley show, Puzzling Evidence, Dr. Gary Brogfran, Dr. Howell, and various insidious guests, Mobius Rex and so forth, and evil subgeniuses.
Evil.
Intermixed with a tape from...
It's all intermixed, dear friend.
Bishop Huey of Houston, Archbishop of Houston.
There's no such thing. It's all a lie. It's all on tape. We just get these tapes.
That are always labeled tapes. Collages from hell.
And double mixes from heaven.
Through
starring.
So, yeah, some.
Everyone but you, the listener.
Dear friends, once again, as we saw it...
And again.
We come to the end of this side of the show.
Prepare to turn your
once
show
again,
over.
You'll have to...
Turn your show over.
Turn your radio over. Flip it so that you can hear the rest. This is KNON 90.9 FM. The Subgenius Radio Ministry, Hour of Slack.
Just walk away. But I'm gonna try for the kingdom. If I can, 'cause it makes me feel like I'm a man. When I put a spike into my vein, and I tell you things aren't quite the same. When I'm rushing on my run, and I feel just like Jesus' son. And I guess that I just don't know. And I guess that I just don't know.
Welcome to side two of your radio show.
Yes, dear friends, we're back, and boy, it's getting tough doing these shows night after night after night. It's easy for you. You only have to listen once a week, but we do 10 shows a day. We have to keep up, stay ahead. What is that noise?
I have no idea. I think it might be the exits on the outside of the hull.
I can hear the hiss, the air noise.
We're still on the fringes of the atmosphere, you know, that's just a few molecules.
What happens if I push this button?
Basic problem.
What?
Running up, demagnetized.
Oh, you can hear us.
Oh, man, no.
Well, golfers. What if we flip this?
Is that a whole week show there? Or is...
Here we go.
Visit land veiled in mystery and magic.
Up there went the mystery and the magic, right there. Why did you have to say that?
Here are heroic legends of ages past, timeless myths, haunting ghost stories.
Hey, is this that Time magazine ad about Vietnam?
Yes, it is.
Jump ship before it's too late.
Okay, thanks. A feast for the eye, mind, and spirit.
We don't want to do that.
I think he's right.
He? What do you mean he? Wasn't that a female calling?
No, I use the term he to describe all aliens that call the show. I don't think humor is ever called.
With adventure as rich and deep as the ingenious human
imagination. If that's an it,
what is that?
I want to get fixed, too.
First time by the editors of the Book of the Subgenius.
Yes, all of the show was getting fixed. They were fixing the show.
Now,
Subgenius
Publishing guides you through this intriguing realm in a unique and spectacular family library, the Book of the Subgenius.
Here we go. Veiled in mystery and magic.
Up there went the mystery and the magic, right there. Why did you have to say that?
Well, Gary, we just thought we'd say it. There went the mystery and the magic.
Yeah, it's all over now.
You use a million gigawatts of electricity to extract souls up here. The energy is released psychoactively and with simple chemicals down there. And we never freebase soul either. I mean, that's really bad.
Just drinking it, that's all.
Drinking it and snorting it. I like a little iced soul myself.
I like it best out of balloons, to tell the truth. That is my favorite way of doing up some soul.
Yeah, tank soul's good stuff. High pressure tank soul, I like.
Just the pure stuff, straight out.
Straight out. That's just they cook it, you know, and then it turns into a gas. And then they pump it under pressure. They scrub it through dog meth filters and stuff like that to make sure because when you get into that excited a state, every little part of the soul separates from every other, so you get little pockets of you know, stuff that was like childhood dogma rammed into you. So they scrub that all out. So it becomes, it's the most pure form in gaseous form.
Oh, yeah, but the only problem is that, you know, the people that end up banging their head against the wall all night long because they can't stop,
down.
They're in such ecstasy or whatever. Yeah.
No, people that fall down on the floor a lot.
Beingness. The beingness of it, they, you know, makes them, for some reason, chew the ground. And that's what I did. That's how my jaw got messed up.
Yeah. You know, you can tell
woke up chewing the ground.
Yes. Woke up
chewing. I loved Mother Earth.
I woke up chewing
the ground. It made a big mess.
Yeah. You can tell that, that the soul really affects people more in gaseous state because the minute they speak, their voice isn't the same, you know?
Well, it goes directly to the main gland, and I mean it just diffuses in the blood so fast.
Put some Barry Manilow.
Here we go. That's a scrambled signal. We have not been able to figure this one out. You can slow it down, and it's like old TV shows. But in between the lines are these incredibly fast little like micro blips of sound that we have not been able to stretch out enough. The best digital equipment, you can't slow it down enough.
Maybe the space is between the blips of the actual message.
Yeah, but we can't slow it down that much. I mean, you can't differentiate. The machines won't. It's alien. It is. It is the truly alien signal. It's
play
there.
Music.
But
it's only 60 gigahertz band, right?
Yeah, that was a great band, man. I wonder what ever happened to them.
They're playing the hydrogen line now, I think. I think this is one of their numbers coming in right now on channel 7.
Here they come.
Stay down. Here they come. Scary little ugly things.
That's a helicopter.
I don't understand why our own church sends these things in to try to kill us on our own show.
Well, it's part of the dogma. Thou's own show will try to kill thee.
Well,
there are little babies back
there.
It's little holographic babies. See?
I'm going down. And I can't... If I can't talk,
I'll vote.
Bye, sir.
The reason why you don't get the slack you need is because you got it mixed up with what they tell you what you should want. Pretty girl, big breast, a big fast car, 75 pounds of cocaine, and real bad rock and roll on the radio. That is false slack.
I still didn't.
And should be handled by church hierarchy. They are poison for you. Poison. They're the peripheral residue left after the slack juice drains out. If you think that kind of stuff is real slack, then you're lost into some delusions that are not your own.
Too much anti-slack show right now.
They're just lost in that TV image, yes.
They're all sitting at home watching MTV.
They're all watching
them. And I can't live with
they're
this
all watching their own unobtainable middle class dreams on their screens.
I'm just going to kill
Bob. It's just
Bob.
Terrible. You ever had a truck roll over your foot?
I'm so frustrated, I just can't.
You ever stood on the edge of a curb
like
and have a bus smack you in the face, turn the corner?
Down,
you ever cross a
busy
intersection on the lights?
Do not be afraid. I am not here to harm you. He's the first of your kind to attain immortality.
Immortality? We're not interested in that kind of immortality.
I know you want to destroy me, but listen. Please listen. I only want to help you.
I've chosen you.
Well, I'm sure that's very flattering, but I must get on with my work now.
Seems better.
Well, we're trying to fly the show tapes out of here now. See, we fly them out early before the show's over. Get them to the other stations, and they play that solid model display software stuff that you like so much here on the air.
What about the fact that
The fact. Wait, a bad word to say. Look what happened. You see, as soon as they say it, the engine breaks down. Hold on, we're going to have to fix things here. Oh, man, I don't believe it. I don't know if I have my wrenches here.
Come on.
Gary, see... Oh, okay. He's trying to get
now,
it.
Now, there's going
to
be some spooky, scary monster movies later on.
This is really going to delay the end of the show, you know, if
we
can't get this thing started and get out of here before Emmett comes in.
Kiss the blood off my hand.
Let's watch that while we're waiting.
I spit on your grave.
No, I saw that on that. So kiss
I
the blood
eat your grave. I eat your skin. Don't look in the basement. And Dracula has wet the bed in the grave again.
Oh, right, right.
And
like
there's scars of Dracula's hands. And Countess Dracula.
The opinions expressed are not necessarily those of this radio station. Before the sermon, a message concerning Bob Dobbs, living avatar of Slack, and saint of sales on planet Earth.
Are we controlled by secret forces? Do you ever get the feeling that free will is a joke? Do people think you're strange?
Do you? Then you may be on the right track.
Are you abnormal?
Then you are probably better than most people. Yes,
your kind shall triumph.
Now, at last, the step-by-step process is revealed. This is it, the only faith that promises action, thrills, success in sex and business.
Bring your weirdest dreams to rampaging life.
Stand erect for your own abnormality.
Bob is a way of life to millions. Half of them don't even know. He's the one true living Slack master with the spiritual know-how to help you bash through the locked doorway to financial heaven. He is the one real shortcut to Slack.
Now, see another dimension on your TV. Yes, fear the stark fist of removal no longer. Become physically attractive overnight. Attain status, luck, prosperity by blowing them off.
Bob's promise is to widen the scope and nature of abnormal behavior, to explore new ways of going over the edge and coming right back. Plus, to bring back those who couldn't make it on their own. To help you create the highest possible earnings from the psychodynamics of abnormality. To turn conspiracy implanted personality disorders around and channel them into an illusion of creativity that will fool normals and get you sex.
Oh, yes, dear friends. Yes, and the Church of the Subgenius that you've been hearing so much about, friends, you can get more information on just how much more information you can get if you'll write to this simple P.O. Box number. That's Bob, friends, at the Church of the Subgenius, P.O. Box 140306, Dallas, Texas, 75214. That's P.O. Box 140306, Dallas, Texas, 75214. And stay tuned for Soul Oldies with Ron Lindsay. He's standing right behind me, ready to take over when this Jimi Hendrix version of Peter Gunn goes off. And friends, those of you, once again, who didn't send in your pledge money, send that money in, or you can, I mean, forget your Slack. That's it. Hear it? Gall just died. So it's KNON, P.O. Box 710909, Dallas, Texas, 75231. Get that money in today. It's all yours, Ron.
Gracias, amigos.
You're listening to the voice of the people, KNON 90.9 FM, Dallas. Praise Bob.
this photograph. It kind of made me laugh. It took me way back, back down memory lane. I see the happiness, I see the pain. Where am I? Back down memory lane. I see us standing there, such a happy, happy pair. Love beyond compare. Look up there, look up there. The way you held me, no one could tell me that love would die. Oh, why did I have to find this photograph? I thought I had forgot the past. Now I'm slipping fast. Oh, I'm in the sunshine, I'm in